Hey guys.
Well, here's the exit video of the 62. You know, nothing better than chilling and listening to some music while you're driving your convertible. But let's take a quick gander at her and we'll go from there.
Oh, well, here she is. She took a little bit of work to get her where she's at. If you remember the front bumper, look how nice that came out. Brand new. Did some straightening on the grill as well. Straightened that up. Did some extra polish. Now the paint still obviously needs to get painted right here. This, you know, there's no fixing all this stuff. So that's the next stop for her, besides the top. Clean the white walls up real good. We got all the windows working. How about that? So much better when you can have all the windows down. And then, let's open this up here. Got some of the stains out, like right here, yada yada. Got most of the mold out. There's still some kind of little stainage, you know, like right here. But man, it's been in there so long, I don't even know if that's going to come out, because I used a whole bunch of boat mildew products and everything and still couldn't get it out. But they are a lot whiter. I mean, they're a lot brighter than they used to be. They finally match the back. Another thing I did on the interior is repaired the steering wheel. I don't know if you remember, this was all cracked up and nasty. So I JB welded, sanded, JB welded filler primer, sanded it smooth, painted it, and then all that fun stuff. Got rid of the big old stereo kind of box thing that was there. And I put in a Bluetooth system. There's the controller right there. And two 6x9s back here, which they sound perfect. You know, you don't need a stereo anymore. An amp and a little Bluetooth controller will work just fine. Got the fuse box back up, tucked in there. Fixed the glove box. You can finally get in here and close it. Very nice. So this, on the windows, this control was completely shot. It was just, and it was filled with sand. It was bad. And then on this window right here, one of the main rivets that controls the arm for the actual regulator was snapped. So I had to take this whole door apart and basically rebuild that. For the window back here, it was stuck on the track. So I oiled that, put that back in. The switch was fine. For the back rear over there, that was just dry as a bone. The switch worked, so grease that up, clean that up. For that window over there, the switch was dirty. That was pretty much it, but I, you know, greased up the door and all that stuff too. We got a brand new mirror right here. Cleaned up all this chrome, all of the chrome. All the chrome's been cleaned up, even on the seats. So that's, you know, that pretty much does it for the interior. Well, besides, so the visors, the brackets are broken, and the owner opted not to get those yet. And I told him, I said, well, you know, $200 on eBay when you decide to do it. It's just a few screws. You can do it yourself. Let's go around the back here. Now, you might remember how bad this back bumper was. This was just completely covered in rust. There's still some pitting that, you know, I'll never be able to get rid of. But man, this back bumper sure came out real nice. Looks amazing, doesn't it? So, when he does go get the fenders painted, I'm gonna go over and do a whole complete buff on this vehicle. But yeah, and then also, of course, the hubcaps got all the black tape that was on there. I don't know whose right idea that was, but these hubcaps sure did turn out real nice.
There's a close-up for you.
So found out that this actually was a factory mirror car, but I couldn't find a passenger mirror, so found a temporary driver's side, just kind of put it on there for now so you don't look at three holes. Let's see, I think that's pretty much it. Went over all the electrical. Let's go over the engine compartment, I guess, right? So this, shine that up, put the blower motor and resistor control in there, cleaned up the engine compartment a little more. Carburetor has been rebuilt. Put a Petronics ignition system and a coil in there. Now the coil was mounted on the firewall for some reason. I have no idea why they did that, but I put it back into its original spot. I've connected the TV rod back up. That was disconnected completely. And I have a feeling that driving it around for years without that on there and manually shifting it kind of destroyed the transmission. I don't think it needs clutches, but I just really think it needs a valve body service and a pump. The pump gone over. So he's going to take it to KBL Transmission in Huntington Beach, which are some of the only guys that I know that actually know how to work on these old Jetaways. So that's where it's going to be going pretty soon here. And then a new top. And then, of course, the fenders painted. And that's pretty much, I mean, she's a done car, you know? Done car. So I just thought I'd do the exit video for you guys and show her a little bit of differences that I made to her. But she she's a good cruiser, really good cruiser. And then once she's got the fenders painted and a couple other things done to her, man, she's gonna be one hell of a car, because this is a rare option vehicle, you know. Well, anyways, you guys, so the next video is going to be continuation of the 52 and installing the motor. Let me show you the motor. You guys are gonna like this one. Here she is. Got the motor mounts on her last night. Exhaust manifolds are on. Carburetor's coming back off to do install, but just thought I'd do a little bit of a mock-up here, you know. But man, she is pretty, isn't she? Anyways, you guys, I will talk to you soon, and hope you have a great weekend. And like I said, if you guys are interested in any Cadillac Coachworks shirts, just shoot me an email at CadillacCoachworks@Yahoo. Don't forget to subscribe and share these videos with your friends that are into Cadillacs or any old car, you know. And let's just keep this hobby alive. You guys have a great one. Bye-bye now.